Okay, and let's back to the show. This is first Selena Gomez, who happened to be the producer, executive producer of this show. She bought the right of this book, and she tried to make the movie out of it. She signed for the role also, but she doesn't do anything because she start to know that the story should be longer than the feature film, and someone else want to make the mini series. So she the creator contact the Selena Gomez, and they start this project, sell the right to Netflix and release the 13 Reasons Why as a mini series to about the 13 episode, and each episode have a 1 hours. And the person who direct the pilot and the second episode, no other than Tom McCarthy. Tom McCarthy is a director of Spotlight, who this film has won the Academy Award for the best picture in the last 2 years, I guess. And no one seemed to remember that Spotlight win the best picture Oscar, but it's very well directed, and I know that why Tom McCarthy want to direct this project, because it's in the wheelhouse. It's about the people and the character dealing with it's kind of like a detective story, very suspenseful. It's 13 Reasons Why in the same way, and at the Spotlight also. But the one of my favorite the Tom McCarthy is The Visitor, which I recommend everyone else who like a drama movie to check it out, his film. Because The Visitor is dealing with a lot of
Absolutely.
emotion
That's
also
fine. I was just very
about the
concerned about that.
people.
I think, what we saw when we were
And in
shooting
that
that she's
movie,
on a world tour
Richard
and she's
Jenning
flying to so many different
is
countries.
at his
But even though
best,
she wasn't, she was
and
also
he
very
also
emotional when she did
nominated
speak.
for a
And
best
was the
actor
last scene
also.
where Mandy
Please check it
decided
out,
to come out and
Visitor.
hang out and reach out and also
And
realize
let's
that
talk about the
even though
acting
they were
here.
watching dailies all
The
day,
Hannah
Mandy is
played
still
by
very
the
emotional
Kathleen
and
Langford. Kathleen
has
Langford
deserved
is
him so much credit and praise
have
because
her
it's
big
been a long
break
time since
here.
I've been
This is a
to a
first
film where
role
I've
for
felt
her
confident in
as
the
the
director and the
series
story, and I
and
really hope
as
that this
the
film will
feature
help me either
miniseries.
or next
She
time.
is not American, which w amazed me and very
Just a
surprising
question.
me, because
Just
her
having this discussion today,
she is
it's
Australian,
great to
right?
have a
But
talent
her American
like that
accent
who's
is
able to translate like
flawless.
Hannah, I think,
I
kind of brought it to life.
don't notice at all with about
Although I would say that the
her
whole cast
accent,
for me is amazing.
and
Every
her
single
performance
person
is
is
even good,
class,
because
and not because of the reasons
as an
that they
audience,
were
I don't
cast,
know her before,
but
so
that
I
they were able to
convincing
explain Hannah's
100% that
situation
she
to
is
me
this
in every
character.
event that had happened. And at that point,
And
when
another
I had
person is
particularly in
Dylan
my head she was the
Minnette.
person, it was actually
He
Jenny that I
is
felt was the person
play
who
Claire here, and
was
he
able to
appears in a movie called
converse
Goosebumps.
with this kind of thriller
And
and
he is
want to find out more
great
about
here,
her and
because
how
I'm kind of amazed of what is his sleeve, because he played the same character all the time, but this movie proved him that in the future he will become the promising actor for sure. And one of the favorite characters in the 13 Reasons Why is not Hannah, it's not Clay, but it's Tony. Tony is a character. Okay, one, he is gay, right? So I have to like it? No. It's just one of the reasons, but his character is so cool, so calm, and so grounded, and he is like an angel figure in this series also. Okay, is another person is one of my favorite. Is Hannah's mother, Kate, played by Kate Walsh. Kate Walsh, I know her from Grey's Anatomy, and she play a different character in the 13 Reasons Why. She is a mother that get through a lot of emotion and have a different range in this episode. As the audience can see the flashback that she is really happy with her life and her family, her daughter, even though she doesn't know anything that happened with her daughter at all, which is kind of very tragic when she discovers more and more about her daughter, and she have to dealing with the courtroom, the lawyer thing that she gonna sue the school for responsible for the for her child to become a suicidal or something like that. And truly heartbreaking scene that she discovered that her child is dead. So let's break it down to the in structure of this 13 Reasons Why. One is melodrama. Melodrama in this picture is very grounded and everyone can relate. It's not a CW level. It's not a Gossip Girl for sure. It's very serious. It have a serious tone. It have a light tone. It have a realism about it. So I kind of take it serious also, and very more realistic for any teen who watching it and can relate it instantly. For the number two is have a lot of flashback scene because we have to present the present and the past. With in the middle is Hannah's suicidal, right? So the director distinguished style that with the present it will have a core environment, core color of display of this texture of the scene, and in the past it will come to use the warm color because it represents the Hannah figure. When Hannah's present, it will be a warm. If Hannah not present, it will become the cold or something like that. And let's talk about number three is have a very sensitive subject about suicidal and not consent of the rape, which I kind of surprised and shocking when I discover more and more about Hannah's life that she will have a dealing with the rape herself. That's why it drove her in the suicidal. So if you are raped by somebody else, please get help by telling with your family and your friend as soon as possible because it will help you. And it will help you in physically and mentally also. Because when you think about suicidal, the suicide will prevent by not other people but yourself. You have to be responsible for you and responsible for your mentally also. let's talk about the diversity. This show have a lot of diversity. We have gay character, we have a black character, we have a Asian character, we have a Mexican character. And when you watch the show and you see a diversity, you can relate. As a gay Asian guy, I can relate as much as possible because the creator knows how to put the diversity in the story without a distracting. So the structure of this show, it will have you the edge of your seat and you will enjoy each scene as much as possible. And for the season one, I have to talk about or call the season one because it's end with a lot of things that hanging, such as who killed Alex. Alex not die, but someone shot him. And who have a gun is maybe have a three character, more than a three character who have a gun. So the story in the season two will be revolved that who is shot who and what the situation the parents of Hannah's parents will get through on this later or something like that. Or Claire, who driving a car with Skyler and Tony, which way that Claire went.
Everyone is just so nice until they drive you to kill yourself, and sooner or later the truth will come out.
This show resonates me the most. It's helped me a lot of ways to look back in my past and happy that I am not enough like a Hannah situation, Hannah fate. And I know for sure that somebody else is not agreeing with me. Somebody else complained that 13 Reasons Why is not the series that prevent the suicidal, but even more courage the people who have a depression, even more suicidal. Or someone doesn't understand the situation and look at this show is very nonsense and very ridiculous. No one else think about this because you have a happy life in a high school, I guess. And fuck you. Fuck you, you saying that, because this is very sensitive and it's not ridiculous. For the people like me who have not happy thought in the high school, I like this show a lot and it's one of my favorite show in the past decade. I recommend everyone to check this out. And this is Hawk signing off. When it's only a game and I need you, listen to the words that you say. It's getting harder to stay when I see